Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Ellison Cruz, and as the sun sets upon Prelude Beach, I'd like to welcome you to apparently nap time here in the post-game continuation of Pokemon Legends Arceus, where we find ourselves seeking out the legendary plates of old, deciphering the mysteries of myth, and returning to where it all began. And at the end of the last part, Kamado once again challenged us, this time in hand-to-hand combat, where he has a bit of an advantage, if you ask me, but as he gazes out to the ocean, indeed a place of beginning. But alas, no words, fight to the death. He has bloodlust in his eyes, and it's time to rematch the commander himself. Even though, our last battle was 2 episodes ago or so? Well, very little has changed, including his magnificent mustache waving in that beachy breeze, but ooh, what a throw. That was kind of a cool animation. He did it almost so hard he fell over. I don't think he did that last time, but pretty neat. His team remains somewhat unchanged. He does have a surprise addition, but this golem will go down by way of overkill. So, oh, this poor golem. It didn't even stand a chance. Kazumasa, I'm so glad you were leading. So Heracross, a little bit scary against Kazumasa, seeing as how, it is a dark type, and we also have this man here. So I think I'm actually gonna go ahead and swap out because I don't know if I'm good at it. So we'll go, go Zoroark. I am a little nervous because it knows close combat and also pin missile, which is kind of a cool move. But just to kind of even the tide a little bit, I'm gonna go with some Bitter Malice. It's not gonna kill, but we'll get close. And if we get the Frostbit, that'd be hilarious, but not the case. So Pin Missile once again, not very effective, but if I can, let's maybe go for Shadow Claw. There we go. I do have Extra Sensory though, that's why I picked you. Didn't need it, got the critical. I don't think Extra Sensory would have one hit, so I at least wanted something else out of it, but Pin Missile in this game is kind of cool. Now Snorlax, a little nervous about that because it knows High Horsepower. Don't like that. Let's go ahead and swap, actually. We have Lucario for a reason, and I'm just worried that if it uses High Horsepower again, it could actually body me. No pun intended. So, we're playing old musical chairs here. You know what? Let's go ahead and bulk up. Because we're going to lower our defense after using close combat, I would like to get some reassurance in there, and there it is. Oof! Yeah, do it with your whole chest next time, man. So Snorlax's defense is actually surprisingly low compared to its special defense, so we'll go close combat. And I'm hoping that you actually send out your Clefable next. So it cancels out our buff, which is fine. It's good, because now we have, yes, Clefable! Okay, so I actually got a new move taught to Lucario, and it's Steel Beam, an extremely powerful special type steel move, and it is insane because when you use it, it actually halves your HP, so you have to be very careful when utilizing it. But look at this. Oh my god, that is amazing. I love it. The recoil might be a little too much. Yeah, oh my god, I am a dead man standing. Oh no. No, survive the Esper Wing. Yes, yes. Okay. All right, we actually got very lucky on that. So Braviary, of course, Flying Psychic, probably not gonna stand much of a chance against that. So I'm gonna say we'll send Kazumasa back out, or I could be a troll and roll out with Quilava. But yeah, basically all of our moves here would be pretty great. All right, Lucario, you did well. This has been a pretty great fight, actually. The first time I did this, I was having a little trouble, but let's go with the Dark Pulse. Make sure we really put it in the ground. I'm sorry, Braviary. Had to be done. Once again. Yes. And with that, we have won the rematch. It was a little wobbly, but we still made it through. Even frightful creatures like Pokemon can become powerful allies. Are you just now realizing this? Yeah, and a pretty decent amount of experience to boot. Nice. So I did go ahead and complete the research tasks for Cyndaquil and Rowlet, as well as their evolutions. So yes, in the 2 episodes since we last fought, I did get extremely strong. But Pokemon are not dangerous enemies, they're friends, allies, with whom I can reach great heights. along with iron and wine. Perhaps you are a divine being yourself, sent to bring us gifts from above, seeing as how you're still glowing. But upon defeat, he grants us the fist plate. It's beautiful. When the very first of our galaxy expedition team, myself, Benny, and the others, set foot on Prelude Beach, we found that plate. We thought it was garbage, but I decided to treasure it above all. I find it fitting that it should now end up with you, who likewise arrived here on the same beach, along with 90% of the village. Perhaps something is guiding us. Indeed, it must be so. It appears as though we're all being guided by the one called Almighty Sinnoh. Well, it might be more appropriate to call this region the Sinnoh region. Yeah, kind of a hackneyed way of sort of, I don't know, retconning that into the lore. He has no right to say this, but we're truly fortunate to have been able to count you among the Survey Corps ranks. If you had not joined us, we would have fallen on Mount Coronet. That's right. You would have lost your home and your future. Now then, carry on with your survey work. The knowledge that you collect about the wild Pokemon of this region will serve to illuminate our path forward as we walk into the future. You also glowing like a shining person probably helps too. Yeah, so Mistress Kogita sent us on a quest to collect a couple more plates, and this being the first is probably one of the easiest ones to grab. But as we walk away from the beach, oh, this song is so good. It rarely plays anywhere else, and if there's something to be said about the soundtrack of this game, I think it's really underrated, because people don't normally, I guess, perceive the soundtracks to Pokemon games as being all that good, but I don't know, something specifically about Arceus is, like, great. Where did Pokemon come from? Yeah, maybe talk to your parents about that. But, yeah, thanks to me, Hisui has finally accepted everyone. So, you don't actually get an opportunity for this song to play very often, so I'm sorry that I'm ruining it by talking over it. Now, where we actually want to go next is back to Galaxy Hall, because we have the last component of the Zeke and Wanda saga to go ahead and finish, and it involves us heading back here and speaking to them once again. Alright, Mr. Zeke, what do you got for me? Wanda snuck out of the village without telling me and she hasn't come back. Yeah, so she was all bundled up against the cold, so he's got a sneaking suspicion she went to the Alabaster Islands, the last place that we need to search for her. Well, whatever sent her out there, it doesn't seem like it was on assignment, but what else could make her want to go to such a dangerous place? So, once again, he's going to recruit Ursaluna and I to use the scent from Wanda's old kerchief. Of course, as you would expect, you'd think we'd have that memorized by now. And this time, he's actually going to go out there searching himself. He can't stand by and rely on me every time. He's her big brother. That's right, expect the unexpected, bitches. Okay, so why even bother, like, recruiting us if you were just going to run off anyways? Anyways. Oh, my savior. Hello. Who's playing Foo Fighters? Did you see your brother? What? My brother went to the Alabaster Islands? You know, if you run out the door right now, I'm sure you could probably catch him before he leaves. Wait, Zeke, that brother? The one who refused to even set foot outside the village since he got attacked by some Shinx and became totally traumatized? I forgot about that. That might as well have been Akari's storyline, right? Well, anyways, because she is bowing down at my feet and calling me savior, I guess we have yet another Security Corps member to save, so sure, we'll go and do that. Now, I'm not entirely sure if it's possible right now, but there is a mission with Pracel that we need to go and do at some point, because earlier we gave her a Krogunk, and it worked to, cure some poison and make you nice with everyone. Oh, here we go. Now we get it. This is a very odd request. It's nothing but a little quick favor. Pretty easy. What's up? It's very simple. Could you bring me 100 medicinal leeks? I knew it. Nope. 100? I love how the music stopped too. Like, are you serious? Well, they're well known for going practically all over the region. They're also called Wayfarer's Friends, whatever that means. So yeah, knowing me, I could gather 100 of them in my sleep. All right, well, that's an easy errand. I guess I'll just go ahead and give them to you right now, since I had the foresight to have them. Here you go. Enjoy. All right. Ah, what fine leeks. I'll be the judge of that. So, she's always running out, and with her constant stream of injured colleagues who are running out there without any Pokemon, yeah, they can make a nice stock for the folks who can't craft their own. And there we go. Easy enough. So, Adamant Mint. Why not just call it the Adamant? Or the Modest Mint? Huh. Okay. Well, at least it's not Modest Mouse. I tried listening to that new EP they released, and I found it very difficult to get into. By the way, just making sure I'm still recording, because I've been having issues with my Audacity freaking out, not doing anything. How is it going, Sue? Now that I have a family here in Isui, it's time to put my roots down for good. You don't say. Okay, well, today's episode is actually going to be a little bit different. We're going to actually head back to the Obsidian Fieldlands and finish off the massive mass outbreaks with our old friend, Mai. So, let's go ahead and do it. I think I did everything I wanted to here in Jubilife, and to the Heights Camp we go. This is something I definitely want to start getting rolling because it's a concept that is going to be very far spreading, and having massive mass outbreaks available to us just whenever is great. Also, I love Munchlax's sound effects. It's incredible. Well, it's been an entire 15 seconds and we haven't seen anything out of the ordinary yet, so I guess maybe we should try being a little more patient and see if something happens. But some short time later, it begins raining. Huh. Well, that's weird as we stare up all nonplussed. Now it looks like it's gonna get worse. Although Munchlax is digging this rain. Are you worried about it? Well, we still don't know what's causing these mysterious massive mass outbreaks. Well, how in the world will we find one? Well, why don't you take a look at your freaking Marauder's map there, genius? Oh, right, I have that. Oh, excuse me. Those are my OnlyFans notifications. Gotta turn those off. Now, look at how many outbreaks there are around here. It is obscene just how many they give us here. Yeah, and there, you have no idea what any of them are, which is a little unfortunate, but we'll have a little get around that before we know it. Oh boy. It's about to get serious, Munchlax. Are things about to get real here? A massive mass outbreak is a phenomenon in which many mass outbreaks occur at once. Go figure. These locations are marked by, huh, on the map, and you won't know what Pokemon can be found there until you go see. These rare outbreaks will dissipate in time, so you'll need to hurry to investigate them, and this entails either catching or defeating all of the Pokemon at that specific location. Sometimes you'll get a new horde that spawns afterwards that is made up of higher leveled and more highly evolved version of who was already there. So that's a little scary. But now that you have some idea on where to look, I'll just spank you on your butt and get you on your way. We'll just wait here. Don't mind us. Alright, well, this is going to be pretty annoying. I have to unfortunately relinquish my shininess, but we have a very short amount of time to go through doing this, and as far as the tutorial stage is concerned, we're probably not going to see a lot of interesting things here, so I'm going to try to make my way through this as conveniently as possible. But as you can see, up here for our first one, it is a Paris outbreak that also happens to have a Parasect in it. So I don't want to deal with that because ideally you would want a Pokemon like Chatit or Starly who will usually end up running away once you get there, because unless we defeat or catch all of them, we're not really going to be able to do much about it. So this is actually kind of going to be a rough run of this, I can already tell. Over here we have ourselves Krikatot. So this will be really nice for us because these guys run away pretty frequently and you don't have to battle them. So for the purposes of the, you know, mission here with Mai, yeah, this would probably be best. And sometimes you get some Krikatoon. But what's weird about this is that it's level 63. Yeah, I don't know how I feel about that. It's not going to try to attack, I think, unless I make myself known, but we got to get rid of it, so turn around, bud. Oh, geez, look at this. That is impressive, my friend. Okay. Oh, there's still another one over here. There we go. Okay. So a new horde seems to have formed, and it's comprised of Krikatoon. Shocker. So we don't have to worry about that one necessarily. But let's take a look at the map again. So we have to head over here. Oh, and also you'll notice that on their icon, if there is like a little star there, it'll indicate that there will be a secondary horde that comes after it. So that's kind of interesting. So here, Grueling Grove, all this. Nice. Okay, so let's make our way down over here as quickly as we can. And normally you do end up finding a lot of exotic Pokemon that don't normally appear in this region, but yet I think for the tutorial, they probably are scaling that back because, we're not finding anything interesting here. Some Buizel? Yeah, I'm not interested in that. Those guys are just gonna hang around and make my life a nightmare. So I prefer not doing that, but let's get out of here. Where are we heading off to over here? It's not near the Heracross, is it? No. Okay. So sometimes you'll get some prompts indicating when the storm is gonna let up or not. So over there, I'm not gonna worry about them because again, I have to catch and or defeat. They won't be scared away by silly tactics, so we'll be fine. And if we start running out of time, I will probably need to brute force my way through some of this. This is a Silcoon outbreak, so not really worth my time either. This is awful. This is horrible. In full transparency, I actually did end up trying to record this segment, but my commentary stopped recording by itself in the middle of it, and I actually came across a Graveler outbreak, and one of them was shiny, and then they all started using Explosion on me, and I noticed then that I was not recording, so that was not fun. I still have the footage, it's just the commentary track. So I've been doing some hard drive maintenance on my computer that I use to record, you know, commentary. It's the only thing I do on it. This looks like Pichu, actually. Usually not bad because they do run away after attacking you, but might not be the best with Pikachu in there. So let's go check up here in the Fluoto Gardens. And yeah, I don't know. I have a feeling that might be like a contributing factor, but I was like really bummed out because I felt like I had a decent run. Oh my god. Okay, let's not bother the Kadabras over here. Abra's another good choice to have because they teleport away pretty fast. But yeah, it's been overall pretty unfortunate this entire recording session. I was hoping to get more done today, but after that really just deflates you, you know? And I was like, I got some time. Why not? All right, now, are you going to be... wait, where are you? See, I would like to find a Stantler outbreak, because that's also what I found in that recording. Because, like I said, you also get their evolutions sometimes, and I happen to come across quite a few weird here. What is with the Silcoon? For the love of God. Okay, at this point, I'm probably... let's go ahead and just go straight there from here. I was thinking about fast traveling, but that's all right. Man, this is rough. We still have to get rid of, what, I guess just one more now, don't we? Or maybe two. Hello, Snorlax. I see you're still hanging around downtown by yourself. No worries. Where? Okay, it was this close. Okay, another Krikatot. Cool. Yeah, this is not even close to showing like how insane some of these encounters can be. I mean, you can come across Spiritomb, not all legendaries, but you can also get your starter Pokemon. It's like interesting. And with the rainstorm may go on a bit longer, we're probably not going to have a lot of luck in finding anything decent. But if you don't manage to investigate three of these outbreaks at this single point, you will fail the mission, but you can start back up right where you left off, so don't need to worry. Really, man? Thank you. What do I have to do to scare you people? There. Be afraid. Be very afraid. Okay, hopefully... oh, man, they'd love to run really far, too. Go away, Krikatot. No one wants you here. Yes, go live with your flock of Drifblim over there. Come on, come on. Do I need to catch you? You're like a low level. Yeah, you're that. All right, one more time. Me and you, Krikatot. We got hiding behind your friend, I see. And it's not going to react at all. Is it? It's stuck? There you go. Get out of here. Okay, now I still need one more, so that's not very promising. Heading all the way to the end of the Sand Gem Flats is not very good for us. But let's hope we can at least get a redemption outbreak here. Give me something cool. I mean, usually I'll at least get like a Chimchar or something, but who knows? A lot of Dragapult here. Luckily, there are no alphas to gangbang me. That's not fun. Come on. What the? Wait a minute. Oh, there it is. Oh, that sound. I already have a shiny Pichu, but this works out fantastically. All right. Pikachu. I should probably mention that massive mass outbreaks are extremely lucrative as far as shiny hunting is concerned. So that is amazing. Okay. Talk about a redemption factor. Let me run over to Romanus. I definitely failed this mission, but that's okay. Because I think a shiny Pikachu is worth it. You know? I don't know about you. But now I don't have to evolve my Pichu. So that's good. Okay, so there was one around here, wasn't there? Let's see. Oh, it's way up here. All right, let's just get a look. If we can at least see it while the rain is still going, we'll be fine. Oh my god! It's a Cleaver. It's a Cleaver. Okay. And Scyther. This is bad. Okay, well, what the game wants you to do is use your Sticky Globs as well as your Ultra Balls, and that's basically how you go through and rapid-fire clear this. So, you just give them the old 1-2, and then you're set. It's fantastic. And as far as I know, they'll keep spawning, but come on. Nice. Okay, that is our first Cleaver. I do have two shiny Scythers that I can use to evolve into Scissor and Cleaver. But at this point, because I was just a little too late, they're not going to keep spawning. So I think even if I did defeat them, nothing would happen. So let's just go ahead and finish them off and maybe hope for the Hail Mary, not have to leave and come back. There you go. So maybe double check, see if my commentary is recording. That'd be nice too. All right, me and you, bud. Ooh, look at that pose. I think he's stuck. Do you think he's stuck? He has been risen. All right. Oh, there it is. All right. Well, enjoy. Yeah, so all of the mass outbreaks completely disappear. And, oh, it actually worked. We got there right in the nick of time. Yeah, when that storm ends, so do all traces of every mass outbreak there. Wow, so we made really good time on that because there was only one more left over here. And usually the game just isn't kind enough to give you enough time to really just soak in all of that. So we lucked out. I will consider that a win, even if it was relatively uneventful. But yeah, having this available from here on out would be fantastic. So there we go. Of course, we will have to continue the trials and tribulations with Mai and her Munchlax in every area of Hisui. And they give you supplies here that'll make it easier to take on these outbreaks in earnest, namely Ultra Balls. And eventually, they'll literally just give you 100 Sticky Globs. So yeah, it's always pouring rain when that happens. It's kind of weird, right? What could that mean? Do Pokemon gather when there's especially heavy rain? I mean, you probably would have noticed that before. Now, was Munchlax reacting to the rainstorm or the massive mass outbreak? We'll have to investigate further, but how to do so? We've got a good look around the Obsidian Fieldlands, but it's only raised more questions. That frown doesn't suit you at all. Kalaba, what are you doing here? You and your built-in umbrella? You're lucky it's not still raining. Well, as we fade to black to explain the story here. Mass outbreaks that occur during rainstorms. Huh. Interesting. Life is full of surprises. You would know. Yeah, it's not often that Pokemon from beyond our world appear at the Temple of Sinnoh either. Nope. Yeah, so she's got it hit pretty much nail on the head. Mighty Palkia might be to consider why this has happened.
Aretsu's shop may be a good place to visit. That girl's place is awfully popular, especially at 3 a.m.
Yeah, so it's a hot gossiping spot, and it's a good thing that we, you know, made kind and merry with her. So, yeah. Plus, she gave us a really expensive haircut, so we actually will need to meet up with them there. It's kind of odd. I'm glad we didn't need to just fast travel there immediately, because there is one more thing I would like to do. As you know, we still have the mystery of the lakes to contend with, and that involves catching the three mystical legendary Pokemon, however you want to call them, at each of the lakes. And I'm just going to go ahead and grab this one right now just to, you know, really streamline our time here. I really don't want to have to spend time going back and forth between areas just to catch a damn legendary that we're going to do the same thing with every single minute of the day. Man, that is insane. I can't believe there was a shiny Pikachu there. I was lucky. Because normally it takes a bit longer, but I think the odds for massive mass outbreaks versus just regular ones are a little better. Now, sweet mother of God. It's beautiful. Again, if you want to, you can get into a battle, but I personally prefer just getting in its face. I think these ones need two sticky globs, and then hope you can catch with the back shot. You don't have any distractions, and usually, yeah, they do bust out pretty often, so let's go ahead and just do this. We have plenty of supplies, so I'm not worried. But with that, perfect. There are two more lake Pokemon left to be caught. Yes. And those three legendaries will also have their own respective research level tasks to complete. So from here, I guess we will go ahead and fast travel out of here. Let's go back to Jubilife. And right as the sun was rising. Man, we've been out all night, haven't we? Alright, well, let's go ahead and get this going then. She's up nice and early, and that Munchlax is so good. Alright, let's step inside. Do I need to pay 500 bucks to get in, like always? No? Okay, good. Oh, hello, there is... Oh, right, she was the original hairdresser.
Like, oh, I see you're almost half my age.
Well, I heard all about these massive mass outbreaks. I bet they're some sort of Pokemon festival. That certainly is an optimistic way of looking at it. Good for you, Oretsu. So here we got a name drop Johto, because we know that exists. On nights with the full moon, Clefairy get together and dance. Well, hey, we figured that out, didn't we? It's basically a gathering of Pokemon that only happens when certain conditions are met. Sounds pretty similar to massive outbreak. Well, yeah, I guess a little bit, but if you think about it, massive mass outbreaks are pretty manipulatable, and yeah, they could just be the festival of rainstorms. Why not? I'll just go ahead and agree, because I like this haircut. Oh, you're still biting your tongue. Well, she did hear something weird from a Diamond Clan friend of hers. Yeah, interesting, because Kalapa is actually, obviously, Pearl Clan, and Oretsu is Diamond, so what was it? Something weird? Wait, the mass outbreak of alphas in the Crimson Mirelands. So I also ended up seeing in that other recording where the commentary didn't go through, four Baneri that were alpha just spawn out of nowhere. So it is possible, and it does happen sometimes as part of a massive mass outbreak, which makes it really annoying and just easy enough to go ahead and hit the reset button, because usually you do want to save scum when doing this anyways. But you know what? I think Lilligan could probably take on the team of alphas. And this is why I'm investigating. Yeah, so as you would guess, our next step is to investigate the Crimson Mirelands. And this one I'm actually pretty excited for, since you do get really good opportunities for not only Turtwig and Grottle, but also Cyndaquil and Quilava. So that's really cool, and usually where you're going to want to go and search for those. Well, I would like to, but I just want to make sure that we have a video here, and we'll probably just pick this up tomorrow, right? Or I guess next time, which won't be tomorrow for me, but I'm really warm. But she'll meet us at the front gate, so that's nice and dandy and all. Run, Munchlax, run! All right. Well, now that we've done all that, do you finally have any new... No, you don't, man. Jeez. Alright, getting out of here. So let me take a look at my sticky glob supplies. Because I think we probably... Yeah, we can probably make a couple here. I can make up to 22. So spoiled acorns from your harvesting, as well as balls of mud, which you can find in the lava dome sanctuary thing, as well as caster ferns that you can literally buy here. You're just going to want to stock up, because you're not going to use any of that for anything else. On top of that, of course, you want a healthy supply of Ultra Balls, maybe even some Jet Balls. I've read that people use these from afar, and it works decently when you're up against, like, level 20 Geodudes or something that you just need to get rid of from afar. So, and Gigaton, just in case you happen to be near a patch of grass. So, I mean, I guess there is something to be said about all these. I just like to stick with the Ultra Balls because they're easy, fun to wear, and they're pretty incredible. So, thank you for that. But with that, let's double check the harvest, speaking of, because, yeah, finally, yeesh, I've been wanting to clear this out since before we even saw the credits and nothing, but, let's see what you got for us this time, sir, Colza.
Hey, great timing, we're done gathering the harvest.
It's a bumper crop, partay. Awesome, which means it's good, we get extra apricorns, and I thought... it must be a different one if we want spoiled apricorns, but you can't, I don't think you can really manipulate what you get here, so who knows. But I'm gonna go double check all this footage and stuff. It's, oh my god, my the numbers there weren't exactly running for a second when I glanced over for commentary, but I've been keeping an eye on it, and it's making me nervous. But yeah, thank you all so much for watching. I'm sorry if this one's a little shorter, but you probably appreciate that. Next time on the game, we evolve Quilava, and we also evolve Dartrix. Oof, I'm actually kind of a fan of these guys. Not gonna lie. Well, more specifically, Typhlosion. Take care, everyone, and I will see you here next time. Thanks for watching.